Well, in my opening statement this evening, the death of America in Afghanistan. Now, people are fond of saying that Afghanistan is the graveyard of empires. Now, historically speaking, this is true. Alexander the Great, the British Empire, the Soviet Union, and now the United States of America have all failed in their geopolitical efforts there. Often, experts attribute this failure to the courageous and noble tribes of Afghanistan who are committed to defeating the invading armies of the West. In reality, though, when empires go to die on Afghanistan's plains, it is not the Mujahideen's sword or bullet that kills them. It is their own ego that keeps them on those plains while they bleed out from mostly self-inflicted wounds. Now, in an opinion piece published in the British Daily Telegraph said, and I quote, "The stupidity and incompetence displayed over the Afghan withdrawal have once again confirmed that the American elites don't understand the rest of the world and aren't fit to govern their own country, let alone the globe." Now, this is very true. America lives in a bubble of its own compared to the rest of the world. And for many years, they have been pushing the American agenda on each and every country, hoping that the rest of the world will continue to see everything the way they want. So for Americans, there's only one way, their way, and the rest of us have to bow down. Well, we don't have to go far to look for examples. Look at the behavior of the current or outgoing American ambassador here in Sri Lanka, Elena Teplitz. She's an ambassador, a representative of a nation in this country, but her actions are like as if she's the representatives of the owners of Sri Lanka, poking her finger into every internal issue of this country. Whereas global convention laws dictates otherwise, but for Elena Teplitz, that ain't the case. If you want to understand the American stupidity, just analyze Miss Teplitz. I mean, Afghanistan is not a sophisticated country. Taliban is not a superior rebel group. So how come after spending over $5 trillion of American taxpayer money in a span of 20 years, they couldn't squash the Taliban and now going back home in shame? Blinded by a simplistic universalism, America no longer understand religion, tribalism, history, national difference, or why countries want to govern themselves. Even the very thing they have been doing to us here in Sri Lanka. Wherever one looks, America's blueprint for that particular country has completely failed. In the Middle East, every country or territory touched by America is in chaos. Afghanistan is back in the hands of the Taliban. Iraq is a nightmare. Syria was the scene of monstrous killings. As the West looked on, and Libya is a calamity. Now, they came here to Sri Lanka and told us that America comes in peace to do business and China is coming to dominate. It's a matter of us believing the BS or accepting the mere facts that's now on display in a country like Afghanistan. Perhaps it's high time that America starts solving problems they have at home, like racism, drug addiction, intelligent education, inequality, terrorism, sexism. You know what? Just go to Google problems in America, and why not pick the first thing that comes and start solving that problem, and then leave the rest of the world alone. Oh wait, there was one president who wanted to do just that, Donald J. Trump. Now we know why Americans hated him. Well, to be fair, some of the Americans. Well, we got a lot more to discuss, and shortly I will be joined by my guest political commentator, Mahieash Sanivaratna, also political economist, Dr. Vagisha Gunasekara. But before that, joining me now is our facts guy, Mr. Daniel Vitharamasam, standing by with tonight's real story on how many countries had to pay the price for America's sins. Good evening, Daniel.
Good evening, Mahesh. The situation in Afghanistan is widely considered to be America's worst intelligence and foreign policy failure. 2 decades, 4 presidents, between $4 to $5 trillion spent, and above 2,000 servicemen killed from the US alone. Some say the amount spent might be over $5 trillion. And after all of this, Afghanistan's leadership fell to the Taliban.
The United States has had a dual role in attempting to appear as a guardian of human rights on one hand and failing to do just that on the other. The recent incidents that unraveled in Afghanistan has shed a lot of light on the historic authoritarian actions of the United States and the process through which the country opens a Pandora's box in foreign territory and refuses to take accountability. In considering the situation within Afghanistan, the world was forced to witness shocking images of the Taliban terror group taking over the presidential quarters of the country. The Taliban group completed their shockingly rapid advance across the country by capturing Kabul on the 15th of August. Back in 2001, the United States was responding to the 9/11 attacks on New York and Washington, in which nearly 3,000 people were killed. Officials identified Islamist militant group Al-Qaeda and its leader Osama bin Laden as responsible. Bin Laden was in Afghanistan under the protection of the Taliban, where the people in power refused to hand him over to the US military. The United States eventually militarily intervened, quickly removing the Taliban and vowing to support democracy and eliminate the terrorist threat. Peace talks between the United States and the Taliban started tentatively, with the Afghan government pretty much uninvolved, and the agreement on a withdrawal came in February 2020 in Qatar. The US-Taliban deal did not stop the Taliban attacks. They switched their focus instead to Afghan security forces and civilians and targeted assassinations. Brutal scenes of people attempting to flee the country as fast as possible, some falling into their own demise, have become common sight today. The United States president blamed it on the military, which they supported and trained for years. The country has come under heavy critique for its management and the shocking timeline through which all of this took place.
Afghanistan political leaders gave up and fled the country. The Afghan military collapsed, sometime without trying to fight. If anything, the developments of the past week reinforced that ending U.S. military involvement in Afghanistan now was the right decision. American troops cannot and should not be fighting in a war and dying in a war that Afghan forces are not willing to fight for themselves. We spent over $1 trillion. We trained and equipped an Afghan military force of some 300,000 strong. A force larger in size than the militaries of many of our NATO allies. We gave them every tool they could need. We paid their salaries, provided for the maintenance of their air force, something the Taliban doesn't have. Taliban does not have an air force. We provided close air support. We gave them every chance to determine their own future. We could not provide them was the will to fight for that future.
It's not a great idea to oversimplify wars that took place around the world, but given the consistent nature through which the United States have failed foreign operations, its understanding becomes important.
This consistent failure is US always had this mythological belief that nation building can happen. If you can raise a 300,000 strong army, but military forces in the world are loyal to the nation. So if it's Sri Lankan military. So there was no real Afghan nation building. So if you don't have a proper Afghan national identity, there is nothing holding the military together. So I think one of the cardinal mistakes the Americans made was that they misunderstood the Afghani ground. There is no way a modern state system can be transplanted above that system. That is bound to fail. So this they have encountered even in Iraq as well. So I think they pump, and I think Biden is not correct when he says there was development. If you look at the breakdown of the developmental aid is marginal. It's less than 10% of all what the U.S. has spent. U.S. has spent $900 million on the war, $89 billion on the Afghan military, right? And last 20 years, less than 100 billion on the total development of Afghanistan. So I think US has got certain fundamentals wrong. That is why they are facing this consequence.
Iraq is commonly found as an example of the United States functioning in an authoritarian fashion without heeding to the voice of its fellow citizens and acting on completely wrong intelligence. The documentary We Are Many covers the exact scale of the protests erupting not only in the United States but in over 800 cities around the world, bringing together over 30 million people. When Saddam Hussein refused to leave Iraq, the United States and its allied forces launched an attack. It began with the United States aircraft dropped several precision-guided bombs on a bunker complex in which the Iraqi Iraqi president was believed to have resided. This was followed by a series of airstrikes directed against government and military installations, and within days, US forces had invaded Iraq from Kuwait in the south. From the start of the war in 2003 until September 30, 2015, it is estimated that the United States spent a total of over $890 billion on war costs in Iraq. Over 3,700 US soldiers were killed in conflict within Iraq. Close to 500,000 lives were lost over the years within conflict. Vietnam is often considered to be a similar situation to that of Afghanistan. More than 3 million people, including 58,000 Americans, were killed in the Vietnam War, and more than half of the dead were Vietnamese civilians. Opposition to the war in the United States bitterly divided Americans even after President Richard Nixon ordered the withdrawal of US forces in 1973. Communist forces ended the war by seizing control of South Vietnam in 1975, and the country was unified as the Socialist Republic of Vietnam the following year. Syria provides another example of US involvement in a long-standing conflict. What began as support for Syrian rebel forces against the Bashar al-Assad government has now turned into a full-fledged conflict with multiple fronts, facing defeat and forcing the uprise of novel terrorist groups such as the ISIS. The Syrian civil war that has decimated the country for 10 years now, provoking a regional humanitarian crisis and drawing in actors ranging from the United States to Russia, appears to be drawing to a conclusion. President Bashar al-Assad, with the backing of Iran and Russia, seems to have emerged militarily victorious from the conflict. The return to high-intensity fighting in Idlib in 2020 created yet another humanitarian crisis, sending waves of refugees towards the Turkish border and adding to the war's already staggering humanitarian cost. The estimated death toll is about 400,000 people. The United Nations has estimated the reconstruction cost within Syria alone would amount to $225 billion. These are just some of the examples where the United States have displayed no planning in terms of making their interventions humanitarian.
It is the responsibility of every individual here and abroad to be aware of the current actions by powerful states so as to hold them accountable for the crimes committed beyond their shores. This is particularly important when considering the United States. Over to you, Mahesh.
Indeed. That is the Derana story. Thank you very much.